Ah, nothing makes me feel more like an old fuddy-duddy than a high school comedy film. The Duff stars Mae Whitman as a high school girl who finds out she may be the Duff. So let's go ahead and get this out of the way right away. DUFF stands for Designated Ugly Fat Friend. It's that kid who other people keep around so that they'll look better, supposedly. It's right there on the poster, so I don't think it's too much of a spoiler. And what she does in reaction to finding out that may be her and her group of friends. It's a typical high school comedy with the ins and outs of cliques and what it means to be kind of a student who is trying to exist in this world and yet navigate all the psychology that comes involved in a social group like is in high school. We've all been there. We've all dealt with it. We've all dealt with elements of this. But boy, this is a modern high school. I'll just say that right off the bat. It always throws me a little bit and makes me feel so old with the way these kids talk and so frankly about sex and swearing. And I'm just like, man, I don't know if I was just like in this bubble in high school, but I wanted like pizza for lunch. Like that was my high school. Anyways, that's kind of beside the point. Let's talk about how good this is as a movie. There's actually a lot to like here. It follows in the footsteps of a lot of high school comedies in that it really rests kind of on its lead characters, right? Mae Whitman is really good, and I don't know, I haven't really heard much from her before this, but she is very genuine and very likable in this. You really get a sense that this is a girl who's dealing with stuff, and some of the acting choices she makes are really interesting and fun, and I really liked her in this. I also thought her chemistry with the lead male in this was really good and really fun. Kind of their friendship, I felt, was really fun and interesting as well. So a lot of that stuff works. Also, it's funny. It's clever. So it hits a lot of those beats correctly as it kind of goes through what it's talking about. And that's really the other thing I liked. There's a really important message here about kind of cyberbullying and what it means to be in this environment and to have these things hurled at you and how do you respond and what do you do? And I think it's a very pertinent message for this kind of growing youth culture, you know, and as my own boys kind of get to that age, next year I'll have two high schoolers for the first time and, you know, I'll have four in high school in the next few years. And it is, I think, important for them to understand how you react to those kind of things and what do you take in on yourself and what do you let go. And I think it really hits on that stuff really well. As far as negatives go, I think it tries to be kind of one of those transcendent teen movies. Like I think of Mean Girls is kind of the example everybody uses. Or even Easy A, I thought was a really good one with Emma Stone. And it just never quite gets there. A lot of that has to do with production value. Much of the time it feels much more like an after-school special than it does a, you know, really well choreographed movie, a well-produced movie, I should say. It has more in common with seemingly like Alexander and the No Good, Very Bad, Horrible Day or whatever that movie is. Like it feels like that, like it's a kid narrating this world and maybe that's a lot of it. Maybe it's the narration. I know I have an issue with narration. It feels like lazy writing a lot of times and when it's used as a plot device like this, it kind of gets annoying to me. Like show it to me on the screen more than you just tell me what's going on. If the writing's clever enough and some of it is here, then it can work. But overall, I think it detracts here and makes it feel a little cheaper than I think this movie wanted to feel overall. So that's probably the main negative. It just doesn't quite ascend to where it wants to ascend. The other thing is, aside from the lead girl, everyone else in this feels really shallow. Very surface. So there's two elements, right? There's not a lot of depth to their characters. And number two, what is there just seems like they're focused on a lot of the shallow things. Even the characters I think we're supposed to like. I guess maybe that's realistic. I guess maybe that's how teenagers are supposedly. But man, I just feel like we're selling our teens short sometimes. I think they have a little more depth in this. And aside, again, the main character has that. But everybody else just feels like, you know, kind of those shallow caricatures of what it means to be in high school. And I think that adds to the cheapness as well. Overall, I think this is a pretty decent movie. I wouldn't show it to my kids probably just because, again, I think a lot of the sexual content, those kind of things, is a little over the top for me for a movie like this. But there are some messages there that I think they should know and should hear. So there is that part of it as well. I think it accomplishes what it sets out to do well, but not perfectly enough to maybe earn it like a B minus. something like that. Thanks for checking out the review of The Duff. I've got more at the website that you can check out. I'll throw reviews over here, links to stuff that other stuff that came out this week. Subscribe button will be up here. As always, love to have you part of this family, this community of kind of, you know, people who love talking about movies and thinking a little deeper about them sometimes. So feel free to comment. Let me know what you think. And as always, 5 extra seconds to hit subscribe, starting now.